So you might ask, why did I drag you through all of this binomial distribution stuff and flipped so many coins? The reason is we're going to move now towards what's perhaps the most deep insight in all of statistics. It's called the central limit theorem. And the way I want you to get there is through a programming exercise. Now, I told you that all the programming is optional, and you can totally skip this one. But I beg you, stay with me. What you're about to see is perhaps the most interesting way to understand the central limit theorem and statistics of large numbers. So in assignment number one, I literally want you to flip a coin 1,000 times. And once you've done this, I want you to compute the mean of the outcome and the standard deviation. Flipping a coin is a random event that gives us things like 0 or 1s as outcomes, like this thing over here. If you do it 1,000 times for a fair coin, you expect the outcome of the mean to be 0.5. You probably have no clue what to expect for the standard deviation. There's a couple of things I want to give you. In your programming environment, you'll find the function mean, the function variance, and the function standard deviation as you've practiced it before. I modified it a little bit to make sure that whatever you do is of type float, which you need for computing the mean. Otherwise, it might be of type integer, and then these calculations all go wrong. Same over here in the computation of the variance. But ignore the float type conversion. Other than that, is exactly what I've shown you before. I now want you to implement the function flip that takes as an argument the number of coin flips you want to do, 1,000 in this case, and then uses the function mean and standard deviation to compute the mean and standard deviation of the resulting sequence of outcomes. This will be a list filled with zeros or ones. The thing to know is that with the function random, dot random, there's two of them, the dot in the middle, gives you a random value that sits between 0 and 1. Every time you call this function, you get a different random value, which is nice because you just have to call this 1,000 times to get the 1,000 samples. But they're in the interval of 0 and 1, and you want to put them back into coin flips. So what you have to do is to call this expression here. And this expression over here will give you true or false, which is the same for the purpose here of 1 and 0. It gives you true if the random variable happens to be larger than 0.5 and false if it's smaller. So if you somehow call this thing 1,000 times and make a list of these 1,000 outcomes and put that code in the function flip that returns that list, then you're done. So here's a typical outcome for this code. If I run it, the mean might be 0.484. There's a standard deviation. If I run it again, I get a different mean, 0.51, and a different standard deviation.